All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to ARK Survival Evolved. We're still working on our primitive run, which we're not allowed to build anything in a fabricator. We're not allowed to build fabricator at all. So I'm waiting still for hair to grow for the animal tender. But in the meantime, I decided that I wanted to do some caves because there are some logistical issues to overcome. So the most difficult of these is going to be the lack of a gas mask. So that makes the swamp cave terrifying. Last night I dropped off a saber tooth in the cave. He's set to aggressive. I'm taking my terror bird over now, which is the one I'm actually going to ride through the cave. And I have a very angry dimorphodon on my shoulder. Other than that, I only have the grapple, my food, drink, and healing pots. Oh, and the hammer of doom. The doom hammer, yes. Just in case things go terribly awry. So, we're just going to park you here. And we'll put it into turret mode and neutral. That way it doesn't die. Because even a big wyvern can get eaten over time. Leave it on passive, yeah. So, we're going to have to be very quick. The health drain is bad, but not insurmountable, as long as you're very quick. And I think we can do this just by using healing pots. So, we're going to try to heal through the pain. The saber tooth is set on aggressive, but for some reason it's not fighting. So we're going to be very quick. We're going down the left side. And the terror bird is out of stamina, of course, because of the mega nera. So I'm going to take the cat back out of the gas for a little bit. So the trick is that we've got two dinos, and if you're not riding the dino, its stamina will stay up. So you can use your second dino to escape if need be. And we're going to feed him up. And these two dinos were already prepared for caving. The Sabretooth doesn't have an extremely nice saddle or anything. But, normally gets the job done. So we're just force feeding him healthy. And then we'll go back in. We've still got 78 health pots, so quite a ways to go there. And, I'm just gonna pause while we do this feeding. All right, now we are healed. The saber tooth is healed, and the terror bird is still down there. So we're gonna have to keep a weather eye on our health, because it does go down pretty quickly, even with the amount of health that I have. So terror bird follow. So we've cleared two hallways and one room. We're going to switch back to the terror bird. But we also need to get these leeches off. And same for the cat. And keep stoking our health. That looks like it should be clear. Oh. Another Meganera. More Meganera. And the saber tooth appears to be stuck. Got him on stock. Now the terror bird's stuck. Apparently I didn't pick up my Dimorphodon before I came, which could cause some complications coming up here. apropos. Now, if I recall, I have to go through here. Don't know if they'll fit. They might without me riding them. Oh no. That didn't work well at all. Arthropleura. So, this is going to be rough. All my healing pots are in there on my corpse. Well, there should be some couple here now, because I was still building more when I left. All right, let's, where is my other fire wyvern? I mean, I guess it's not super important at the moment, but I should probably find that at some point. He was supposed to be tethered. Should have grabbed the Dimorphodon so that I could send it in ahead of me in that room. And it's been a while since I've done this cave, so I'm sure that once I've done it again, the following runs will be easier. Because I'm going to have to do it several times, obviously, so that we can do all the bosses. But it is a lot to keep up with, having to constantly manage your health on top of everything else. Alright, let's put that little guy into turret mode. And hopefully get off of him. Jesus. Fucking wyverns. Alright, and now for a quick run to the corpse. Neither of you are going to fit through there. Come on. Back out, please. Please back out. Shit. Now I'm in a bad position. That snake is sitting right over my corpse. I've got 10 health pots left. I know that my hammer's on my corpse foot broken. They are just as stuck in there. So, no matter which way I go, I don't fit with a tank. So at this point, I'm going to call the gear lost and get out of the cave. And the biggest loss there was actually the food and drink. Okay, so got you there. Disable turret mode. Oh, come on. Alright, so we're gonna run home. We're gonna take the terror bird so it doesn't get eaten. And we're gonna run home. We're gonna make a whole lot more pods. And we're definitely gonna grab the Dimorphodon before we come up this next time. Now I know what you're thinking. What good is a Dimorphodon going to do against all that mess? And the answer, at the very least, it'll be a distraction. no, Lightning Wyvern isn't following us. We'll worry about it later. We do still need to find the other Fire Wyvern. No idea where it's got off to. Oh, there it is. It's back. Well, in that just jumped dandy. Okay. So, I'm going to re-equip and make a whole bunch more healing pots, and then we'll try this again. Alright, so now we're back at the cave, and Lightning Wyvern found us. Apparently it got stuck in a tree or something. Now, I'm a bit heavy for my Terror Bird right now. And I probably didn't even need to bring it back, but I figured better safe than sorry. So... we're going to start off by eating one of our custom food, which has healing effects itself. So, the Dimorphodon on my shoulder is set to aggressive. So, when I throw it, it should just go ape and murder everything it can see. And so here we are at the passage. And there he goes. Get this Terror Bird out of the way. That is just heaps of stuff. Leech is fast enough. Alright, so Dimorphodon died. And I need to get these leeches off of me. That Dimorphodon did do a good job. It tore up quite a bit. Go! need to gather some materials real quick. There's that, I guess. The throwing axe from the Viking pack is not terribly durable. So now we're down a Dimorphodon, and I don't know how well that's going to work out. I don't know how much further we've got to go. As I said, it's been a while since I've done this cave. Long time, in fact, since we've even been on the island. So it's almost impossible for me to tell. What I am going to do is I'm going to run down and I'm going to grab the saber tooth. And I'm leeched again. Come on, you. Out and get unleashed again, and the saber tooth can actually carry our weight, so the Sabretooth is just barely able to fit in the cave at all. Alright. Lit ourselves on fire a little bit. Had a good time. drop a bunch of this extraneous stuff. And then we're going to want to heal up before we go back in. And hopefully we can get in there, get the artifact and get out. I'm not even worried about the equipment, though if it is still there I will pick it up. I did see the green marker when I was in there last time. So... need is a flamethrower. That would be great. Just a flamethrower of some sort. Not asking for much here. And leeched already. Alright, got all my old gear. Follow me out here. Oh. Little ones will. So now I'm stuck in an impasse because if I go forward, I've got to deal with swarms of stuff. Which is precisely what the Doomhammer is for. However, if I start getting hit, my ability to keep my health up while fighting is, suspect. So I went through there, and I did not see the artifact. I should probably go de-leech myself. Because the leech is causing extra drain on my health. However, at this point, I just want to be done with this. So, I'm just hunting for the artifact. This goes to the one where I died, which I've been on the other side of that. Apparently I've gotten disoriented, so I'm going to head back out and then come in fresh and see if I can find it just based on the memory of pathing. Seems like a terrible plan, but we're going to try it anyway. Both me and the cat are leeched, and yeah. Should probably resolve that pretty quick. So if I remember, you go in and then you have to loop back around yourself. So come back where you've already been. And essentially, you just end up on top of that first room. So I come in here. Down through the Watsits. And the artifact, I think it's just right up here. Kind of above us. So we take the left. And we take the left. And this leads us down and around. Into the spiderweb double drop room. And then it should be right over here. We go up this tunnel, follow it to the back, crawl through here, and poof, artifact. Right, so I did all that wandering around and dying and murdering because I went the wrong way. But now we've got it. It can be done without the gas mask. And the next couple of runs should be easier because we actually know what we're doing. So, you and my boy are gonna stay here with plenty of food. On aggressive. Have fun. And I am gonna sod off. So, for the time being, I believe I'm going to cut this video short. That way it is just the swamp cave, and people can see swamp cave, no mask. I'll tag those so that it's easy to find.